clothes that escaped the Great War. Not the familiar ghosts, the shaggy dog of thorn waste that appeared only to children, the chains clanking from the gyme seat, nor the black barge at waterside. These were the most scary, my mother recalled. Clothes piled high on the wobbly cart, their wearers gone. Overalls caked in dung, shirts torn from the muscle strain of heavy hemp sacks, socks matted with cow cake from yards nearby. And the old horse plodding on the nod. Its uneven gait never varied, whether coming from farms, where lads were collected like milk churns, or going back, with its harvest of dungarees scented by first fags. Notes in pockets to sweethearts, boots with laces undone, jerseys knitted pearl plain around coke fires. And the plod, plod, quadruple time, then the catch in the plod, from the clank of loose shoes, from wind galls on the fetlocks of the horse. Each missed beat on the lane, a missed beat in a heart. As a small girl, she could see at their windows the mothers pressing memories too young for mothballs into lavender bags, staring out propaganda posters, dreading the shouts of telegraph boys from lines of defense and attack. As the harness creaked and the faithful old horse clopped forward and back, the lads were new dressed in the years never to be had, piled higher than high over the shafts of the buckling cart.